Being on tour for me is, it's the best feeling in the world. I mean, it's just like, it feels like the place where I'm supposed to be. Like whenever I'm being hard on myself and I don't feel confident or I don't feel loved or worthy of love, all of that goes away when I get back on tour. There's something about being on stage that makes me feel so connected and just so alive. Fans who had seen me a bunch of times came to this tour in Europe and they were like, this is the Halsey that I've been dying to see. I think the best way to understand me as an artist is to come see the concert. When I'm on stage, everything is just so natural. There's no time to overthink. Every reaction, every action is in the moment. I'm motivated by looking into the crowd and seeing people come alive, seeing them shout words that I wrote maybe in a time of weakness or in a time of vulnerability or in a time of joy, and I wanted to share that joy.
Right. Can we do a show?
Yeah.
You wanna
do this?
Christ. Yeah. Ah! That's how I feel.
Yeah.
Are you guys Welcome having to- a good time?
I am.
It's actually pretty incredible. I can catch literally nothing except a microphone.
I could never hold a perfect thing and not demolish it. What am I thinking? What does this mean? How could somebody ever love me? Talk to your man, tell him he's got bad news coming.
I spent my whole life going to shows. Going to concerts was like a huge part of, I mean, what formed me into the person that I am today. I used to camp out at shows. I camped out to see Lady Gaga in New York, but I went with a friend and we slept on the street, and it was the first time that I'd ever camped for a big concert. It was one of the most life-changing experiences that I've had with music. I just would have done anything. Nothing else mattered in that moment but that concert. Whatever bullshit was going on in my fucking life, all that mattered to me was getting into that show and getting to feel a part of something where there was a community in a world that was almost designed for people like me. And I wanted to create that for my fans too, that feeling of you're entering a world that's designed especially for you.
I have legitimately not slept in 2 days.
Yeah,
so here's what we do, then screen. And then during that'll be the waterfall moment,
yes,
while Ariana and I are downstage,
yes,
back to back. She's playing guitar.
That's your
I'm singing. Day. That's a photo op.
What's going on? What the fuck is going on? I just want this each panel to shut down one at a time. What it started doing was great, but it just needs to go like done.
My fans have really embraced that sense of community. I see them help each other. They're always looking out for each other. I always joke around my fans, it's like a beautiful thing, because like I don't really get to make friends that often. Just because I'm so busy. I mean, this is my life and I'm friends with the people I work with. They're my family. But, you know, I kind of live vicariously through them. They all live in that world. They live in this little world that, you know, I created, and then they defined, and they colored in, and they populated and flourished.
How long have you been out here?
We are since Elf.
Elf? You're front row now.
I know. I'm so happy.
Biggest tour yet, not in terms of size, just in terms of the magnitude of this, the creation of everything. We spent months putting this tour together. All of the visuals were really carefully constructed, and we worked really hard to build a set list that really told a story.
I want to tell you a story though, is that okay? On the sides of it, down here in the front, who made it possible for me to come perform for you tonight. So everybody, let's say thank you to them. Everybody, let's say thank you to them. Say gracias!
I have an incredible team.
Are you ready for this show?
No.
What are you thinking?
I can't remember any of the songs.
The visual department at Moment Factory.
I agree, actually. It makes the show different also.
Well, I think it feels more cinematic that way.
Yeah, and that's the first note you gave
us. We're not trying to rush through it. We're trying to tell a story, and we're taking our time.
Danny, who did all the choreography and blocking.
I also love that the two of you think that the only thing that I know how to do is grab my crotch and squat. So I can't wait for you to see my actual concert. Now I feel like I have to prove something to
you guys.
We're
just living our pop star moments.
Yeah. Also the aerial team, who helped me with my crazy idea of wanting to be in the air. And I got to look everyone in the room in their eyes at some point, and they could go home from the show with that moment of like, I looked at her, she looked at me, like we saw each other. I felt you, we felt each other, that was a real moment.
But they need to see me because that's usually the part, I'm usually spotlit for that, and I kind of like, I pace with them like 2 feet, and I go,
everybody, like, put your hands as high as you can, and then higher, and then everyone's like, what's going on?
And the drums kick in with the lights usually is how I do it.
It got really strange by the end of the tour, obviously because the world was changing so fast, and when you're on tour, you live in your own little world with your own schedule and your own things and your own family and your own, it's kind of like we're in our own little neighborhood, our own little suburb, like all of the buses just like camped out together, and it did start to get really scary. There was really big shows happening. I mean, we sold out the O2, which was probably one of my peak career moments, when up there with like the top three shows I've ever played in my life. I mean, that show, I've never felt anything like that before. I don't know, it just felt like everything was right, like all the pieces came together, and there was like mosh pits, and I would just remember looking out and going, holy fuck, this is my show. Like, this is my fucking show. Like, it was insane.
All right, walkie. Not yet. Biggest headline show of my career, guys.
Woo!
Let's go. No big deal.
I've been looking forward to playing this show for a very long time.
And I'm like, oh shit. That is a lot of people. Wow. I talked about wanting to take a break. It's funny how things work out, because now I am on a break from touring way sooner than I expected to be, and I already miss it more than anything. You know, I'm confident that we're all gonna be singing together again very soon. It's cheesy, but music is, it heals. It heals people, it brings people together. It's a language that everyone speaks. You know, Manic is an album about me, but it's an album for them. It's an album about believing in yourself and accepting yourself. And Manic is an album about not having control, but being okay with surrendering. And I think that a lot of us can really relate to how that feels right now. So I'm really happy I wrote that record, because I know I needed to say it, and I need the reminders now more than ever.